auditors that we have, they went in that direction. We heard about this, seen the offices, took all the hard disk on the computers, started to contact all the banks. And we are planning, to have more the facts on the table.
Now, the employee says he just wanted to increase the profits for the company.
Right.
Do you believe him?
Well, that's one of the things we really want to look into. It wasn't any profit now, so it's all on the company.
There are some security measures that have been installed directly after this man turned himself in.
Right.
Why weren't these there before?
It's a good question. We thought that we have went through this rather quite in detail. It happens to other companies before us. And this is something that shouldn't happen. It shouldn't happen in our company.
There were several places where this could have been caught.
Right. First of all, why didn't people react close to him? That's one thing we really want to learn more about. And also, of course, why didn't any banks react, since this was quite a strange operation, and in the end, it was quite a big volume. Basically, it seems that the banks were very happy because they got some money out of this transaction also, but at least somebody should ask some question to somebody.
This was about $24 million. How will that affect Electrolux financially?
Well, if you compare to the size of the company or to the total profit, it's only a couple of percentage of the profit. It's quite a lot of money. And of course, a lot of people that worked hard in order to earn this money, manufacturing vacuum cleaners and refrigerators, are very upset. But if you looked in the perspective of the total companies, it's a lot of money, but not much when you look at the size of Electrolux. It's very embarrassing and we're very upset, but it's not affecting what we are doing in other parts of the world or in other operations.
Lars Göran Johansson, Director of Corporate Communications for Electrolux. The company is not sure whether insurance will cover the loss, but the annual report due in February will have to inform the market how the company will withstand this $24 million scandal.
Dodie Axelson reporting. On Monday, Sweden's National State Railway System is losing its monopoly. Altogether, some 60% of the national rail network will be taken over by private operators. Some observers say this will create healthy competition, while others wonder why dividing a national monopoly into regional monopolies will make a difference. There's also criticism because buying tickets will get a lot more complicated. Here in Sweden's Bill Schiller asked journalist Mikael Österlund of the Swedish business daily Dagens Industri what the change will mean for passengers.
In one sense, it will be more difficult because if you go into the state railway to buy a private ticket only, that will be impossible. But it will be no problem if you would like to buy one state railway ticket and then a connection with a private railway company or vice versa. That would be no problem. So there will be some slight problems in the beginning, but the companies and the state railway are working to get the system work better and better all the time.
Trains have long been facing tough competition from people driving cars, from freight people using lorries and trucks instead of the trains. Just what will this mean now for competition for the entire market?
The biggest thing is that the state-owned railway will get tough competitors. The travelers will compare the wagons and so forth between the companies, and they will also compare, of course, the conditions if they can buy cheaper.
kindergarten, let parents leave the children overnight while they took up the hotel and champagne offer. In near misses, one baby was born on the afternoon of New Year's Eve, and two others were born on December 30th. Otto is offering gifts worth over $6,000 for the first baby of the new year as part of a project to repopulate the region north of Lillehammer, and the Red Committee for the Winter Olympics for Health. Finally, in the far northern Swedish city of Luleå, suggesting she might have another, more questionable profession. Lily insists that leaving the graffiti in sight will spark a badly needed debate on school discipline and parental responsibility. The graffiti scribblers have now been revealed, but Hilly refuses to turn them over to authorities, saying this won't stop vandalism at schools. It will simply overburden the top administrators who don't have time to deal with it and will boomerang back on her a ton of extra paperwork. So, Hilly the Whore remains on the walls, and the debate rages on.
And we'll be dipping back into the fun file in 2 weeks. That's all for today from Radio Sweden. We hope you can be with us for our weekend programming. Tomorrow, in our monthly current affairs magazine, Sweden Today, we'll be looking at three high-profile business deals, two that are going ahead and one that collapsed. And on Sunday, there's another chance to hear Ace of Base and Sounds Nordic as we also go through the new singles chart and meet a new band called The Buzz. We'll end today with Ava Dahlgren and Vintender Shannon, who likes the stars. Thanks for listening.